in my car after Post Academy. It's like me and three of my buddies. You're not videotaping me. Bullshit for a thing. Hold on. Let me see if I can find it. This one might be hard to find. Oh, I found it.
What you got going on, Gabe?
What kind of Aya?
What you got going on there?
Come on.
I might have to chug this beer while I'm waiting.
Die of Unsatan. You listening to Tool?
Oh, yeah.
That's one of my favorite Tool songs. I just listen to every day going to this. And I time it so I got there in a specific part. In the summer with the common doors off.
Broadcast live about the whole world. The whole world, dude.
Bilingual bitches! Bitches, Galaxy S7 Edge.
Yeah. Well, I think better is a Note 5.
I don't know. You heard what I did, right?
I don't know.
I left it on a front bumper of my car.
Yeah.
Only my dumb ass.
It's okay. We forgive you.
Hey, my phone did not have fucking scratch on it.
Good.
Whoa. I think this might be it.
McSevity kitchen party.
All night, every night.
We're going to be in 5 days, though.
One of the things we really love about FlexSteel
is the quality of
construction is second to none. If you come into our showroom, we'll show you how this furniture is made. We'll show you the steel that they use to reinforce all of their frames. We'll show you the attention to detail and the tailoring of the fabrics and leathers. Quality is unmistakable.
I gotta show you this.
Quality FlexSteel furniture. At Levin.
Sure, Steven bought for 4th of July.
Levin, not Levin.
He's getting
Levin. Levin or Levine?
LeJew.
He said LeJew. That's funny. LeJew. Levine, Levin.
LeJew.
Whatever.
What? Why are you buffering? Fucking hate
Did
my
you pay
internet.
Your bill?
Yes. There's not a red light on it in there.
I may drink one more beer before I go home.
Yeah, I can't say. Pay me my money down. Tomorrow is our saving. Pay me my money down.
Okay, your phone officially sucks.
You officially suck.
I know, I do.
Balls.
I'm not trying to set any trends.
We're trying to pull one out that we haven't.
What?
I don't know why he was doing that.
Yeah, you don't know why.
Weren't you just on your phone acting weird?
All day.
Maybe your phone gave my phone a virus.
Oh, it did.
So this is going out loud. How do you know people are telling you that?
The church is the viewers now. Look at this show.
What? Bitches!
I know.
It's a movie!
It's a movie for millennials.
Watch it!
Watch it, bitches!
Yeah.
One, two, I was mad.
does.
Here we go. We got the Laurelwood song. Gabe McSevenny song.
Did I melt this somewhere?
I don't know, your song. Your...
Or did you randomly turn the stove on where you're asking?
I didn't touch anything.
Randomly. And Tori's gonna choose
better.
And there it's 22, just to get over you. My belly aches blue, lorazepam blue. I'm down for the count, always three times a day, sometimes four, sometimes four.
Because I can't remember anything else.
I don't even know how I know that. Except that I'm psychotic now from, like, hanging around.
Why? Getting somebody to throw a big ball of shit at you? I love it. Fucking Steven goes, seriously, 5 minutes after you left, he starts throwing shit again. What's hilarious is I had a long talk with him before I left. And I introduced Steven to whatever his fucking face is.
Yeah, that big retarded dude.
Yep. And
what the fuck is up with that dude, man?
He's fucking... Like...
Shouldn't parents serve responsibility once in a while, you know? These parents... Actually, I heard something funny on, like, I was listening to Rush Day on the radio, and he was like, at some point, parents decided it would be a good idea to be friends with our kids. And that's when they got all screwed up. Because they want to be friends with our kids. And that's so true, you know? It's like, you got to be a parent, not a friend, you know?
My old man looked at me one day and goes, if you ever think I'm your friend, you're sorely mistaken.
I know, my dad was like that. He was like, I'm not your friend. You're not
he didn't become my friend. He didn't become my friend until I was in my 20s.
Yeah.
Which I know is a lie, but he was a parent. I don't think he was being a parent anymore.
Well, parent first.
No. And the thing is,
mother,
by that time I always knew he was going to be a parent. I always knew he was a
parent. I heard you call, wanted to sail upon your waters. As I was you seen it all. You seen it all.
I was your height about 20 years ago.
No. What's been to ruin you?
I had the amount of hair you had about 46 years ago.
You don't want all this hair.
No, I know.
It's an extra $20 a month. Treasures.
I gotta go over to my house tomorrow and pick up I'm gonna take a picture of me when I was 18.
You see about $250 a year by not having hair.
Yeah.
Yes, I am a pirate. 200 years too late. The cannons don't thunder. There's nothing to plunder. I'm an old reporter.
But you know, there's always a way to laugh. You might as well just
drink.
She wanted the attention. And then you saw that shit with
she
the chick
on. She waited for me to get there. And she fucking started cutting.
Yep.
I was like, is this what you want for me to hang out with you all fucking night? She's like, I was like,
that's what you look at her.
I'm like, you're a fucking child.
And you thank God that there's no cameras or there's no microphones. And you go, you're like, keep acting like a fucking retard. You're never going to get out of here.
That's why I told her. I was like, you want to stay here forever?
Because I told that to the kid.
That's going to happen.
I had a kid. I'm walking out of his room. There was a rumor that he was hiding that.
Oh, yeah.
He was taking on, storing them. You know, like, kid fucking overdosed. So I had to go. Last thing I said, I barely like doing skin assessments on the adults.
Yeah.
I've done enough. I've done enough to fill a fucking 300 page book.
It sucks.
No pussy fuckers. You need to catch up to me. That one. I really don't want to be arrogant about, but because for the longest time I was the only nurse, the only male.
Well, you're a male nurse.
Jan wouldn't do them unless they were on a young kid.
That's funny tonight because that fucking idiot. We see his better laid back tonight.
Yeah.
Wow, that was like a shit night.
I walked
back in the office after my break, and John's like, hey, good time, man. It's your time to do this next step. Is it this thing? I was like, you know what kind of fucking night I had? I was like, where's the fucking draw straws? You know? I was like, I'm not fucking doing anything. He's like, we'll do it together. It's okay.
Listen,
John Simon actually had my back.
John always.
He knew I was in a bad mood because all the shit that I went through tonight.
Listen, John's always. John might be a fucking liar. John might be a fucking asshole.
But he's a good liar.
Asshole is a good dude. You'll always have your back. And I'll tell you what, he'll take a punch. And this is what I'm trying to tell Dawson the one time. When John was. And Dawson wanted to kick the fuck out of him. I'm like, Dawson, we'll fucking turn you into an asshole, bro. You don't want to tangle with that.
I'm not even sure Sean is a tough dude, but.
Nah, Sean is a tough dude.
He's not a big dude at all. He talks a lot of smack, but.
He's a tough kid.
I mean, I got about 50 pounds on him.
He'll still mess it up, but he doesn't care. He might get his ass beat. He'll tell you that.
Occupation, old hazard piece. Occupation, just not around. Feel like I'm drowned. Gonna hit a turn.
John's coming around, you know. It takes a long time to walk to somebody, you know.
Oh, it does. Yep. And the more he busts your balls, the more he's warmed up.
He never busts my balls, but he knew I had a bad night. And he was the first one to, like, help me out, you know?
Yeah. You were going to get any help from a fucking retard nurses over there.
Well, you know what?
One of the things we really love about
no offense against anybody else, but everybody was scared tonight.
The construction is second to none.
Lindsay didn't want to deal with anything.
You come into our show.
She was scared tonight.
We'll show you.
That's the worst.
Susan was scared tonight.
We'll show you the steel they used to reinforce.
Susan is a...
We'll show you.
No, but you know, don't...
The detail.
She's a... tailoring. A very, very nice woman.
Quality is unmistakable.
But you know, though,
she's so worried about her job. Like, she's so worried about the particulars of it.
But you know, though,
she doesn't do it.
Anybody in that hospital tonight, if they were scared to be on that unit, they had good reason to be scared on that unit. Because it was a really fucked up bad night. You know? And that's why I was okay with, like, Lindsay. When Lindsay was, like, not around that much,
yeah.
Around, and, like, I was, like, fine with that because I don't want to see a girl get hurt. And that would have been the night for somebody to get hurt tonight. It was a bad, bad night.
The shit was going on.
There was girls trying to fuck up people. Guys trying to fuck up people, you know?
But you know what?
It was a fucking psychotic night all together.
Carrie could eat a bag of
no,
pets.
No, that's he's one thing. He's an instigator.
Damon.
He instigates.
He does.
Damon will fuck people up.
But you know what?
Not tough, but he'll fuck people up because nobody else is going to get back.
Damon will always talk to me.
That freaking Lindsay chick? She'll beat people up.
You know why I wasn't? I walked out of there.
Jordan? She's tough. She's a tough chick.
She's an Amazon.
Yeah. She did the fire academy. She knows how to, like, she's tough, you know. She's punched me, you know. I know she's tough.
But
it was a bad night. Like, you don't want to be female night, you know.
David, I can walk down that hallway and I can read the right time. I guarantee you.
Oh, I can too. Obviously.
Exactly.
Yeah, I can.
David was a problem.
I walked up to him right away tonight. And, like, nobody, like, everybody else was like, I don't want to deal with that.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what?
You don't know what? Do you want to know why I left? When that bitch on the lounge fucking staples in her mouth. And
yeah.
Because, you know what? Nobody out there had a goddamn plan on what to do.
There was no
plan. None of the nurses.
There was no plan.
None of the nurses on that unit had any fucking clue what to do.
Even the
Rachel?
Even the supervisor had no idea what to do.
You know what? I still had work I needed to get done on my unit. You know what? Fuck that. I gotta get my shit done.
Well, I told Nick, I was like, you guys got this? I'm like, we're behind on checks. That's the number one thing for us, right?
Well, yeah, especially with the way that unit is right now.
I was like, sorry, I gotta go. You guys can handle this.
I walked out, I was like, son of a fucking bullshit. And then I walked over to my unit, and I go, take that, you guys aren't like assholes like they are. You guys are your own brand asshole. My one guy wife goes, he goes, that's funny.
Paul really likes this website. I don't know what it is. I don't know what this app is, but whatever. But he's got 26 followers. See if we can't up to that. My name's Raymond. And in less than a week, I'm going to be in South Carolina drinking beachy drinks on a beach.
Go, Skip.
Say, pretty happy song there.
What?
We get a followers here. We're going to keep, like, posting videos about working in a psych hospital. A psych hospital. That's it, dude. That's more of a phrase. There better be. I'm still trying to drink off the crazy.
I'm still trying to drink away
the ticks.
I'm still trying to drink away the Hep C. In desperation.
I got blood on me today. I was a little rich. Well, this chick was 18 years old.
The Stevenson's Burgers, and you played.
Yeah. Shout out. Yeah, you know, I got blood on me, but this chick was like, she wasn't a slut. She wasn't a drug addict at all. She just had like a break. So I knew she didn't have anything bad on her, you know.
I had a patient of mine at 16. Because, why do you always wear gloves when you is an Afrojack? Why do you always wear gloves?
You never beat some shape.
He goes, it's not like you're, like, drawing blood. I go, I had a dude, like, I did it one time, I didn't have gloves on. Like, right after I started, I go, well, number one, I started bleeding everywhere. It's like they were on blood generation. I go, second of all, 90% of you guys have fucking Hep C.
On your unit, they do.
I go, I like to keep my liver Hep C free and the rest of my body disease free. Unless it's a disease I earn, like lung cancer. But if I were to get lung cancer like my old man, I'm not gonna lie, I'm gonna look at you and go, bro, you're a target. Okay, hey, Paul. Sign up today. I'm like, God damn it. I earned it.
I'd be like, you're so creepy, but I'd be on asthma.
And for the record, lady. Oh, it's up for the record.
What the, oh my God. For the record.
I don't.
You don't have asthma, I
don't. No, I only have one cancer. Well, that I'm aware of.
If you do, I'm gonna punch you very hard in the chest. Because you lied. But I haven't.
I haven't been to the doctor in years, so who knows? But I figure my liver will grow before my lungs do.
That's why you need to get a new job, because they're gonna force you to go to the doctor to get the
check on you. Admittedly, it's probably gonna be a tough race.
Hopefully, that's not a little
insane. So what happens when you work at a psych hospital?
No.
Wait.
Come to America. It's so great.
What is this, Yakov Smirnoff?
It's so great. America. America. Home of the free.
Land of
the free. Home of the brave. All we ever talk about is being Irish and German, you know.
Hey, we are two wild and crazy guys. Yeah,
wild and crazy guys.
Two wild and crazy American women.
Michael, they have taken
cheap Russian vodka.
Hey, look at that girl over there. She really dances in the night.
Yeah.
Hey, that guy over there, he was looking like Steve Martin.
So I guess we're going to vlog it now.
Yes.
What is that again?
August 14th.
Okay.
That's all right.
That's, wait, that's Sunday, right?
Yeah.
That's, okay, the day after Danielle's wedding. So I can definitely go to that.
So we're off.
Don't be scared on Sunday, so I'm taking the whole weekend off.
You're funny.
I take off when I'm partying. I don't take off for, like, church.
I'm not complaining about the fact that I didn't get invited to Danielle's wedding.
Yeah.
Honestly, I wouldn't go.
Me and Bob are kind of second-guessing that whole thing. Like, we're like, should we take off 2 days in case you meet chicks? You know, we have fun.
Bob's there.
And I was like, we better wait because it might be really late.
Bob's
married. No, he's not.
We kind of figured something was going on.
Well,
don't try to hide shit around since you're doing this. We know what's going on.
Well, I know
everything. There's been discussions about that.
I know everything.
This thing. We figured Bob probably was booting it out of his house.
Yeah. Yes. Yes. But, so,
I won't say anything, I swear.
Okay.
But just to let you know, you are recording this.
Well, yeah. It's not going to
be. For us, it won't be safe.
Yeah, but not here.
Fucking love it,
technology!
So we're going to Vegas, October 15th, Jimmy Buffett, Las Vegas, October 15th.
For my birthday.
For Dave's birthday.
Big 43, bitches.
Weekend, MGM, Jimmy Buffett, you know, big party. How can you do that, you know? Come on, man, you know?
I'm listening.
That's one of the few parties we're going to attend. But, next Wednesday, we're going to South Carolina. Little River, right? Little River.
Ocean Isle.
Well, we're seeing Little River, though.
Yeah.
Ocean Isle, Little River for a week. That's going to be a big-ass party. I mean, that's going to be like where it's at, you know, a big party.
I'm going to pass out on the beach and I'm going to shit myself.
Well, we'll get you a diaper.
Intentionally.
Nothing like doing it on purpose. But that's going to be a big-ass party, so it's like, I'm hoping that we meet some people down here and they can tell us where to go, you know? I've been to South Carolina in like 13 years.
I do believe that John knows his way around that area.
Well, yeah. Yeah.
Steven already asked me what we're doing after the rehearsal dinner.
I thought it was just like mock master party.
Like,
if anybody can tell me where there's like a strip club at Ocean Isle, South Carolina.
Steve is not a strip
like
club. I would say Steve is not a strip club kind of guy.
Okay, like anywhere from a bachelor party in Ocean Isle, South Carolina. We need to know where to go down here because you do not know where to go. Ocean Isle or Little River. That whole area, Myrtle Beach area. Like,
I mean,
where do we go down here?
It's a tourist area, so I really doubt there's a strip club there.
Come on, there's more. There's going to be a strip club down here.
Well,
actually, they have a really cool House of Blues down here, though.
Well, what I'm saying is, in a tourist area, there's probably not going to be one. You're going to have to go, like,
to the more local. Yeah,
like,
we can figure it out, though. Like, you know, I mean, somebody's going to tell us something, you know?
Like, I started trying to look at, like, restaurants and shit there, like, bars and shit that maybe... Because what I'm thinking is, like, after the rehearsal dinner, you know, Stephanie and the girls are going to go out, and... Like, it's not gonna just be like me, Kevin, Fatai, and Steven. You know, Steven's gonna. I gotta believe that Steven's gonna wanna hang out with, you know, a lot of people that made the trip. You know? Because we're making that trip for him, and we're making that trip for Stephanie. And so he's gonna wanna hang out with. People made that trip.
Yeah, it's gonna be a collective thing.
I was trying to look up like some restaurants, bars.
There's an Irish bar out here.
What?
There's an Irish bar there.
Oh, definitely starting there.
Yeah, it's like a golf theme Irish bar.
As it should be.
Anyway. I'm huge. It's dumb. I'm huge. Gabe, I'm up to 210.
I got man boots. No, I got man boots because I stopped working out, so now I'm actually working and they're just laughing.
Nobody cares.
I do. My 9,000 will work out.
Hey, we're all gonna have fun.
We're all gonna be too drunk to notice anything. Except big boobs on the beach. But it's. Yeah, it's gonna be fucking.
Oh my god. It's gonna be plus 5 a.m. in Cleveland, so I'm gonna finish this very long night.
I gotta work.
I'm not off until Wednesday when I go on vacation.
Well, whose fault is that?
It is my fault. It is definitely my fault. But I'm gonna like record our entire vacation.
You are not. Now, don't turn into Dawson. Don't live vicariously through the camera while everybody else
is. I'm the man. He's not the man, though. He's not even getting permission to go anywhere. He's not even going with us. You got a full beer, man. You got
two. I'm working. I think there's one more beer in here.
What's your point?
You're drinking it.
This way, you're my best friend, Gabe.
You're an asshole.
You're a goonie. You are a goonie.
I am.
You're a goonie.
As evidenced by that.
Well, that's not you, but you're a goonie. Because if that's you, that means I'm chunk. And I'm one of them.
Wait, why do you get to be chunk? All right.
Chunk?
Oh, God.
Are you Jamba Tuesday? Jamba Tuesday's dead, so neither one of us are him.
Rocky Road.
Rocky Road.
Hey, you guys. Hey, you guys. God, I love that movie.
Man, we're retarded.
Say retard. As long as we go to Vegas, I get to play Alan.
We are going to Vegas. October 15th.
I already hooked it up with a buddy. He's going to be back in town from SoCal. So he'll be in town. And like I said, it's one thing with Bob going, oh, I can navigate us through this trip. Well, no, no, no. I don't give a fuck about you navigating us through this trip. What I care about is walking into a casino somewhere and knowing somebody is going to take care of us. And that's what Chris knows. Chris is that one guy that knows everything. like, you are high on the Willoughby? But you and I are on the Willoughby.
This is for you, Gabe.
There are a lot of ways to pack your breakfast with
milk. That's a commercial!
Commercial. Sorry.
Just to just add milk.
Like, you and I are in Willoughby, and going to the pickle and going over there. This is like that in Vegas.
I think you like this.
God, I wish I had my hacky sack.
Yeah, your hacky sack.
What I am is what I am, you what you are.
said. I mean, I kind of like the one. I go, you guys have two choices. I go, you can act like that and it goes better, right? Or you can act like human beings and you guys can sit up, watch the Cavs game when I don't think you're going to bed. I go, you guys get one free pass. My advice, don't call it a free pass.
I get pissed off when I have to treat adults like kids. That's what pisses me off.
I thrive on it,
and that's what happens. And
I love it. It's the only time I ever get to play parent. And when they came back from ARC, my patient.
Oh my god, they get stuff like that.
My baby, well, so yours.
Not that much, though.
1,500 does it tomorrow.
During the day, usually. 1,400, like, no. A week is for complete assholes.
1,500, Friday night, they go to activity survey.
I don't work on Friday nights.
But they came there from ARC, and one patient was like, motherfucking somebody. And she's motherfucking the art teacher, the activity therapist.
Which one? Tracy or the guy?
No, it's not Tracy. It was a female.
The other girl with the dark hair glasses.
I don't know her name.
She's like nice, but she's like very like.
I like her. She's very nice. You know, like, all she wants is for. Not only do her job, but she really enjoys being with the patients. Yeah, you know, she loves her job.
I know, I like her.
And you know, she's such a nice woman. So this patient was like, I don't know if she was motherfucking her or Sarah, the blonde haired cat that we had. She doesn't really work on 1600 very much. But I went down and I go, I go, aren't the rest of the patients going to be pissed off when they find out this is their one free pass, me talking to you about your behavior? She's like, what? I go,
this is for you, kid.
Who are you motherfucking when you walk through that door? I go, because this is my unit. Empire original soundtrack season. I go, and I hear everything that goes on. I go, and you were just dumb enough to walk past me and motherfuck me. God, I got one. But so, well, she's trying to rush me. I go, well, we have a schedule to keep. So if you want to tell everybody else why they didn't go out for a smoke break or they were late for the. Are you having a seizure?
That's why I said I dance. I learned how to 1600, by the way. I learned how to.
I did that dance once.
I learned that on your unit, by the way.
Because our unit's actually fun.
It is.
Yeah. Dude, you would love that.
That's like, I think it's your patients on my units I have fun. Like,
you got a couple of my patients over there, Sam.
That's what I'm saying. Like, that's when I have fun. Like, what's that dude's name? The one you're like, you guys don't like too much, but I was like, I have fun with that dude, you know? He was on 1700, 1600, 1400. I call white dude. What's his name? Andrew? Yeah, Andrew. Look at that dude, man.
Oh, I don't mind him
when he's actually up, man.
I don't mind him when he's psychotic.
He's talking to me like that. He's like,
dude, he's a goddamn juggalo.
Yeah, he is a juggalo, yeah. He calls me D40. He's like, D40, come on, man. D40. I love that dude, man. He's like, makes work going like fun, you know? Makes work fun, you know?
When he's stabilizing.
Yeah, you know what,
when
like,
when he's fucking psychotic, he's a fucking asshole.
You know, though, I don't have problem with people like that. I can handle people like that.
Oh, I'm one of the only people he'll talk to.
Shit, I got called in to work on a first shift for that dude because I couldn't handle him on 1700. He walked in, and I walked in, and he's like, B40, yeah! And I'm like,
shit. I'm getting paid.
Like that
you're
fucker,
paying into this, you know?
That fucker wants to hug me every time he's in there. Like, Andrew.
You don't know, that's a problem.
Can't that hug
place.
Me.
That's a problem to the place. They don't hire on personality. How do you have the dudes have personality doing these people? I don't hire on that.
Colleen.
You hire a bunch of idiots that have no personality whatsoever.
Colleen all but begged me to stay.
Like, they hire people like frickin' like Rachel or Renee or something like that.
And Susan.
Susan, they have zero personality. Zero personality.
And
all you have to do is a personality to like survive.
Now wait, look at the step, look at the units, and look at who works what units. He looks around the house, sees angels in the architecture, swinging. Look at the staff that works on 60. Nursing life. Only nursing. This is all on. Because I'll tell you what, I would take the tax on 15 on any day of the week.
Oh, yeah.
Over Chris. Except for Susan. Except for Susan.
She tries, though. She tries.
She really tries. And that's part of the problem. She tries.
What, are you going to, like, trust her after that?
No. I would,
what would she do if she went?
I would trust the Sharpie marker to have my back. More than I trust her. Because she doesn't have a deal.
Yeah.
Like, at the same time, Marie, who's a nurse.
Actually, Susan would be really good on CMR.
She would be really good on CMR.
Yeah, definitely.
Her skill set would work very well up there.
Well, she doesn't have to be tough to be up there, you know?
No. But Adam's up there.
Would you have balls of being anywhere?
Listen, last time Adam had a fucking code on CMR, he locked himself in the fucking bedroom. And
he's got a brother who's a bodybuilder on steroids.
And his other brother's in a fucking army.
But I'm pretty sure his steroid brother couldn't beat anybody's ass anyways.
I'm not going to toss that theory. I know I'm faster than his brother, but...
Well, you know what, though? I mean... He comes from a really nice family, but, I mean, like...
Sure he does, but he's a millennial. Basically.
Yeah, they're all kind of...
Or he's Generation Y.
No, millennials. Millennials are pansies, though. They really are pansies. And, like, those are the guys wearing man buns, you know, and, like, beards and stuff like that, you know. Like they're all kind of fags, you know. Like, like if anyone got my face, I'd be like, I'll sneeze on you and knock you over. No.
I'm going to share a photo of my Eggo waffle when it pops up. That's so interesting, honey, because I'm going to share a photo of my Eggo waffle when it pops up.
Golden crispy, warm and fluffy
Eggo
waffles.
Adam refuses to work on 1600.
Well,
because he might actually have to be in Arizona.
Shows up like late, you know.
Yeah, after it's all over.
Yeah.
Hey, CMR is here. Yeah, we know it's done. Right. Hey, John and I, we're gonna like CMR, and they call it code 3. John, you're the fucking best friend down the stairs. We're turning our ass down the hallway. Literally,
It seems neither has that much to lose.
probably.
I wish you were beautiful, my thoughts are too clear. But don't run away, my girlfriend's a boy.
Get over there,
my job is too beautiful, hell nobody's perfect. Would you like to play? We're together today.
Adam loves the MR because it's cushy. He doesn't really have to work.
Well, he told me several times, he's like, this is a good job because I don't even have to do a nursing job, you know? He's like, I don't have to be a real nurse. That's what he said, I don't have to be a real nurse. So, like, my point is like, well, okay, you don't have to be a real nurse, but
I hate that. I hate that part.
Well, my whole thing is like, well, I still have to do vitals on people. I have to spend more time with the patients and you have to spend time with them. So, and you're making a lot more money than I am. So, you know what, though? Why should I protect your ass when it comes out, you know?
I'm going to tell you what.
Like, I'm not a correctional officer. I'm not a security guard. But you're talking like that. You don't respect what you're doing. You don't give a shit. So, see what I'm talking about. I'm not paid to protect you. There's nothing in my job description that says I'm supposed to protect the nurse. There's nothing that says that. But that's expected. It is expected. The techs are generally...
Also, keep in mind, though...
bigger people. Tougher people.
Keep in mind, though, there's nothing in my job that says I even have to respond to a code.
Yeah, but you're one of the few male nurses.
Me and Chris will race each other to go to fucking team supports and go.
So it's like,
and I got way more to fucking lose because I got, like, two hands of license to lose. I do. If it gets to that point where it's that physical,
you know,
and I do something wrong, I can lose my license.
So I was really
fucking with a rush.
I don't give a fuck.
Exactly.
It's not my career.
No. It's not my career.
I'm here to protect people. That's it, you know.
It's not... Keep in mind...
I'm protecting staff. That's all I'm doing, you know.
Keep in mind, it's not my career to be there for a career.
I'm protecting you guys.
My career,
like you, you know?
My career is my license. And the shit that I've seen John and Chris get away with, I can't do that. I'll lose my license for it. Birds are chirping.
Aren't they always?
Yeah, apparently. So, when I go to a code, I have to be a little bit more restrained because I have a license to lose. So, I have to make sure that... And I don't like going to codes... Specifically because of the fact... I mean, I like it from... Completely separate from my job. I like going to codes because they're fun.
You get off sometimes.
But the problem is... The reason I don't like going to codes is because... If I'm swapped on 1600 and I get an all-male staff... That's pulling me away from my work. And that, in turn... Joining me behind. And if I gotta go up to the goddamn kids unit where they're gonna spend a fucking hour pulling each other's dicks.
You can't handle behavioral.
Pulling each other's dicks.
You can't handle behavioral people. You can't handle psychotic.
Look at the people that have something up there.
Yeah.
Jill, Amber, Jen. Really? I know there's not a lot of
against them, but they can't even handle their own personal lives.
Yeah, true story.
Nice people, real nice people, but
yeah. I mean, listen, I'm not gonna say anything bad about Jill.
I won't say anything bad about
Jill. Jill's got a good heart.
She's fucking crazy.
Like,
but it doesn't take much to be a nurse.
Not there. Not I look at some of the fucking retards I work with, my biggest fear sometimes for guys to be wearing this stuff when it was off, Lindsay's off, Meatzel, Vicky, yeah, but she went, she's off on vacation today. The three people I depend on that unit, none of them were there.
I like Danielle.
I'm one of the people that train Danielle. You want to know what I like about Danielle?
Stephanie. Great. And not much more than that.
Honestly, the only thing I don't like about the teachers that I'm going to make is Danielle. You know what? She won't shut the fuck up. I'm fucking trying to chart on four people and give me 4 hours. But she won't shut up. And Danielle's power hungry.
Oh, yeah.
Like, Danielle's, the only reason Danielle's a supervisor is because nobody else wanted it. Stephanie was asked, I was asked, it was like a couple other people that I heard were asked. None of us wanted it. We don't want the hassle. In my life. Why did you love me? Or just making a fool of me. Well, I hope you understand. I just had to. I don't want to be a floor nurse. Or I don't want to be. What the fuck are these? Arthur Tardigrams flying here. And how old are they?
Those are really old. I found those in my car.
Oh, you showed them behind my cocaine.
Yes, I
did. I'm going to share.
I mean, my sugar.
When it pops up. That's okay.
I respect like the nurses that deserve to be respected.
My mom even got a laugh out of the cocaine
thing. Skulls must be warm and fluffy egg o' waffle.
Tea, cereal, cocaine, pasta, coffee.
It's obvious the nurses that like, go to school get their associate's degree to make a lot of money, and that's it, you know.
You know what's funny is
girls like Lindsay, who's like super smart, you know, like got a bachelor's degree from Bowling Green, super smart.
Well, she's smart.
Yeah.
You know John fucking busts her balls all the time about going to Bowling Green.
Yeah, but John, really?
Yeah.
He's got like nothing.
No,
and Lindsay's smarter than that.
Actually, John's a smart dude.
Yeah, but he's got nothing to back it up, though. And Lindsay, like, she's more educated than almost every nurse in the building, you know? So.
But you know what makes Lindsay good at what she does? Actually, it's really fucking good. I've been trying to steal her away since she's
on the rag.
She's a brave one, but it's.
Yeah, she's calm and like.
And the patients know that. Believe me, that Aaliyah is a bigger fucking bitch as she is.
She is.
Alright.
One thing about Aaliyah, she's a liar. She lies a lot.
Oh, yeah. But just say it.
She says she hates females.
But yeah,
she's on a one-to-one. She hates females. Clean, she's fucking dumb. One of their asses, you know.
You need to work in mental health. You need a degree, which means you have an understanding of mental health.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I mean, personally, I don't care. I don't care if it's a mental health, but like I said, if I'm Kelly, I'm doing the hiring. I'm going to hire somebody with a degree.
Where's Kelly?
A bachelor's degree. She got the same thing I do.
Okay.
Actually, technically, and I point blank told Colleen this. I'm more qualified for her job than she is. I said,
Colleen. What's her bachelor's in,
though? Nursing.
Okay.
I go, Colleen, how many degrees do I have? She goes, you got a bachelor's in nursing. I go, number one, I go, the fact that I asked you how many degrees I have, you go, that's a loaded question. Yeah. By the very question that tells you I have more than one.
Yeah, she kind of like, when she asked me, she kind of like, well, what do you have? I was like, well, I have 2 associates, a bachelor's, and a computer certification. Or a certificate, whatever. And she's like, really? I didn't know you had that. I'm like, you hired me.
Yeah.
I probably have more than every nurse besides Dave and Bob, you know, and I'm a health technician besides Lindsay, you know.
Well, you got Lindsay. There's quite a few. Believe it or not, there's more touch than I had a degree. Randall's got a degree.
Oh, I know. That was kind of a joke.
But,
you know.
There's a lot more touch there than either has a degree
or
almost done.
By 3 degrees and a computer certification.
But, well, the point is, if I'm doing Colleen's job and I'm doing the hiring, so let's say I'm looking at you, your prospective applicant.
Put people in the right places, you know? Like,
you know, your prospective applicant. And now, Jillian's got a goddamn master's degree, but she's fucking retarded. I mean, more patients come out of her groups, and, like, the patients that I have good rapport with will come up and tell me, you know, because they know my sense of humor, and I know theirs. I've had patients come out, the one dude goes, Jesus Christ, Gabe, I'm more suicidal now than I was when I went in. He goes, and I wasn't even suicidal when I went in, but... Listen to her, made me want to kill myself. I go, dude, I don't blame you. I go, you should hear her over at Paige, makes me want to kill myself. He goes, like, how the fuck does this fucking stupid bitch still have a job? She falls asleep in her own groups. Her own group, she's running the group, she falls asleep.
Like, I was.
She's running. As much as I don't like Sandy, as much as I can't fucking stand Sandy, and I wish I would have heard Jillian threaten her, she threatened the fucking nurse.
You don't know, like...
Now I'm going to tell you what, I don't tolerate that for my goddamn patients. I'm certainly not going to tolerate it for the fucking staff.
I was doing a walk with her, and a patient came up to me. They wanted to talk to me, you know, like, bonding with me kind of thing.
And then
she got upset about that.
Did she look at you and go, and did she raise her face and go, I'm the nurse.
And she's like, I'm trying to talk to Paul right now. We're doing something. I'm like, no, it's about the patient. If somebody wants to bond with me, it's all about them.
If somebody trusts me enough.
You can hang out for another 15 minutes and do your rental with me. But if a patient wants to bond with me, talk to me, That's more important than you walk with me, you know?
Yeah.
And she didn't get that.
Bad fucking four eyes.
Yeah.
I refuse to work with her. Fucking funniest thing ever is out of this. So I'm charged nurse one day. And you know, a lot of times like when I say my unit, you know,
yeah.
It's because I'm
unit. This
is my unit. This is my gun.
No, I get it.
Yeah.
1600.
A lot of it has to do with the fact that me and Stephanie.
Well, that's where you're always
for
at.
A while.
That's where you're always at.
We're always there.
I'm using 1400. I get it. You know, like,
and
when I talk about where I work,
it's a gift.
And 14 is your unit.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
It's your unit, and it's like Bob owns that unit. That's Bob's unit.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like...
But he doesn't spend time with that one guy.
No, oh, God, no. He doesn't spend a lot of time like the one I play, what I do.
Oh, my God. I'm only burned out the way I am because I went that all the time.
And it's mentally exhausting.
Yeah. If I call, I'll tell you right now,
you're gonna sleep on that fucking flight.
Well, tonight, like, I called the nurse down to talk to this chick. You know what, though? Because I talked to this chick for 15 minutes. Oh, big deal. Because I spent 6 hours with him, you know? 6 hours. And he talked to him for 15 minutes. Don't tell me about bullshit, you know, because you don't even know.
I don't even care. You wanna know what?
Because I told him, I was like, as soon as you walk away, you're gonna start doing it again.
You wanna know something
Come
funny?
Come back in 5 minutes, you're gonna start doing it again.
You wanna know something funny? Kyle, the guy that they admitted?
Oh, I know. That fuck.
Yeah. Well, you wanna know something?
He even knew it. He knows he fucks up.
Yeah. Oh, he told me he fucks up.
He's like, I'm fucked up, you know? He's like, I'm walking out of the fucking sporting goods, and then, broke my foot.
You know what the... I wasn't even working...
want to be here, don't you? Yeah, I want to be here.
I wasn't even working on that unit tonight. And I'm going to tell you what. When some of that shit started going down, and I walked, because he's in the first room there.
Yeah.
And I was on his pass, I hear, hey, Gabe! Kyle! No, bro! He goes, he waves me in. It took me all of 10 seconds. I was like, God, what happened? He just stopped. He's like, yeah, I tried to walk out in front of a car tonight. I was like, dude.
How big was it? It's not big enough, I guess.
I go, dude. I go, Kyle. Did you ever think?
I can hear you.
I go, did you ever think? Basically all of 10 seconds, 15 seconds, just to talk to him for a second.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, and I'm not even worried about
it. At least he knows he's a fuck up, though, you know? At least he does.
And I told him, I reassured him, hey, I go, I'd rather you be here than a fucking hood owner in somewhere.
Yeah.
But I was like...
We really care about everybody, you know, but sometimes they just gotta, like, fucking get a grip on themselves, huh? Come on,
you know, they do. But I'm going to tell you, between 14 and 15, at least they're looking at it and go, you know what? They are mentally ill. That's why they're there. Some of them don't deserve to be admitted.
Some of them just want a free ride.
Some of them want a free ride. Some of them get admitted because they made stupid comments.
Right.
Some of them don't belong in there.
Yeah, but some of them make stupid comments, but they don't want to go to jail.
Yeah, they usually end up on 16. It's called drug addict. But...
What's up with that? Canton, Ohio. Youngstown.
Warren.
Medina, Warren.
Warren.
All those places are...
They're really shitty places to live.
You don't live there, ever. Because they all end up going to mental institutions.
Yeah.
When's the last time somebody from Willoughby, South Euclid, Mayfield? No, nobody from those areas go to.
No, actually, we get a lot of people from Lake West.
In a world where business is so unusual, one man seeks to change it all.
Like,
I'm Andrew Zimmern, and unusual is my business.
One more song.
But kind of going back to what I was saying
one more
was,
song,
don't you wonder who was the first person who was like,
kind of go back to what I was saying though. If I'm doing a hiring, I'm going to look at somebody, honestly, if I've got the choice between somebody who's got a master's degree and is like chilling in, or an associate's degree.
But you got to look at their...
Yeah, I'm saying...
But you got to look at their, like, job, their, what they did before that.
I don't give a fuck about that.
They can't just have school and not a job.
You know, I don't give a fuck about what they... I'll take that into account.
Yeah, well...
I'll take it into account. But what I want to look at is the person.
Well, yeah, that I'm saying, like, their career.
Jillian's fucking...
What they've done, you know?
Jillian's fucking retarded.
Like, what is she doing before she did that?
I found out Joe Colleen, after the one day that fucking Jillian worked on 1600... I go, if you never put her on this unit again, I will fucking walk out.
Like I said, like, I had a problem with her because, like a patient was trying to talk to me, and she got pissed off. She's like, well, I'm trying to tell you, you know, what's going on here, you know? I'm like, well, the patient's more important than what you're telling me, you know?
Hey, look at Jillian, go, Jillian, shut the fuck up!
Yeah.
It's bad enough you piss the patients off, you're not going to piss the staff off.
Well, she's mad because the patients like me better than her.
Well, listen, if she can get away with telling somebody to go shut the fuck up or leave me alone, believe me, she says shit to me, I'll be like, you're goddamn retarded, shut up. Who the fuck are you?
She's a retard.
Like I said, though, if I'm doing the hiring, I'm looking at the whole picture. And I'm gonna tell you what, if I met somebody like Jillian who got a fucking master's degree and worked at a retirement home, but got fired from it, well, I'm not gonna say that. Let's just say she left. See? Let's say she left on her own.
Man.
I'll use this only as an example, but let's say you applied for the job, you got only an associate's degree, but you're a personable guy, and during the interview process, I realized Jillian's fucking retarded, and you not only have an associate's, but you have a, you know, I can already tell that you've got a good rapport, that you've got a good rapport, and we're clicking, and I look at you.